was even set up as a volunteer program. A couple of friends came together, and we sought to make a change and a difference in the community. So we were doing this, for this particular, we decided to focus on the street kids and the homeless, which is pretty much a bigger objective compared to what we usually used to do, and something that we couldn't do it alone. So we decided to go out to social media within our platforms at work, at our schools, and call up people and try to educate them and bring awareness to the need to help those that are on the streets.
Right, so how long has your organization been operational for, and how much have you done to try and alleviate the plight of street kids and the homeless?
But specifically for the street kids, we've been on the ground, and we've been functioning for this particular agenda for this particular year. And we've got people on the ground who have been interacting with these kids. The thing that triggered it is I have a kid who's on the street. His name is Ofwan. He rushes my car frequently. So I see his drive and his desire to just, you know, do something honest, honestly. So through interaction, I try to discover what the story is all about. And I find that it was the economic hardship, the abuse at home, that made him go out to the street. And from there, he began telling about other friends that he has on the street as well, who have not chosen to be there, but are still so desirous of the mentorship and just the love, you know. So we began to talk to more of these kids. And then within that conversation with a number of the street kids, we found one guy who actually was on the street for 7 years, and then he reformed. And now he's a business person, and we're pretty close. So we discovered that, look, these guys have a chance. It's of course not going to be all of them. It's not going to be 100% statistic that are going to be changed. But the very few that we can change, we decided, look, why don't we just give them what they need and they will mentor them. Because our objective is this. We can't take them off the street and put them into a place and expect them not to go back onto the street, because the street for them is now a drug, you know, besides the drugs they're taking. But what we do is we inject the consciousness of their relevance in the street. We interact with them there. We show them that, look, God, you are more than what you are, but you've got hope for change. Once their mind has been formed, then we find ways of planting them into orphanages, into schools, and into that.
Right, so far, how many have you rehabilitated?
Coming from the 23rd of December program, we've identified 50. And out of that 50, we are expecting perhaps about 25% who will then pull in, and then we will focus on intensely throughout the year 2017.
Right, and can you just tell us more about the program that you're going to be embarking on the 23rd of December?
The 23rd of December will be at the City Bowling Club, which is by Harare Gardens there. We've decided to make it exciting for them, because the first thing the street does is, before it strips off your intelligence and puts you to drugs, it strips you of your dignity. So we said, look, let's return the dignity to show them that someone out there really cares. So we're dressing up the City Bowling Club as a shop, a proper shop. Like you're walking into Jets, there are going to be shelves of clothing, shoes and everything. All these have been donated by so many people in Harare. And we're also going to have a little lunch section. And then on that particular day, they're going to come in. We're going to give them free haircuts, free braiding and shampooing of the hair. These are for the girls and the guys, of course. And then we're going to give them an option of selection of clothes. This is the buying. And the only thing that they have to use to buy is their name. Because that's what we want to give them back, the value of their name. Street kids is just, it's not who they are. It's what the result of whatever caused them to go on the streets made them, yeah.
Right, this is obviously a very noble thing to do. But do you think this sort of thing is going to work to try and get them off the streets and rehabilitate these kids so that they can fit back in society?
We definitely think so. Because you find that, as I mentioned before, the street, it strips you of your dignity. It makes you lose the hope. So what we're trying to do is give them back hope. And then we identify them who has got potential in certain areas. Some are very artistic. Some are very sporty, you know. So you find that in 2017, there will be a program that we are doing, which is a soccer fest. And from there, we identify people who are into football and into business, and it's just interaction. And from then, I tell you, they'll change.
Okay, well, that sounds really good, and I wish you all the success in this particular endeavor, because it definitely will make these kids really feel good and worthwhile. And there I was talking.